samurais meet. This feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away.
Yeah. hi, just like Pepe. Huh? Say hi.
What are we doing?
Putting a penny in my shoe.
Good luck. Good luck.
Oops.
Bring it back, Will.
Back, I gotta go there, drop the beer and stuff off, and somebody's gonna follow me at the church and drop off the car.
Mom, why don't you? Oh, you gotta go home and get one.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Mother of the bride.
Yeah, there's gonna be enough people over there to.
After the ceremony, you're gonna go back and get your car?
No, I'm gonna do it now.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna go there.
I'll do it now, but
wait,
I can't drop
it. Is that alright?
You can't, like, see it.
No, inside.
You want inside?
Ma,
that's gonna feel weird.
It doesn't matter. On the arch.
Isaiah, you can't wear my shoes.
How did your skin come up?
I took off.
Like
there?
Yeah!
What's that? What's that? Give me my kiss goodbye. I love you. I'll see you in a little while, okay?
Come here.
Oh, he's so used to video cameras. I don't know why he's playing camera shot.
Good one.
See you in a little bit.
Hey, Josh. See you in a little bit, a couple hours.
Actually, well, I'm gonna get him to see if he can bring me back.
So I can drop my car off. Hey, Josh. Should have thought of all this stuff before.
So let's hang the boat.
That's the photographer.
Oh.
Actually, they were filming that Guys Gone Wild video, so I just got my shirt off. I hope that wasn't on.
Okay, I'm hopping in the shower for 5 minutes. It's gonna smell a lot better in here.
What's the deal last night?
Yeah. Hey, who wants to see?
Oh. Like that.
I'm gonna flush down his.
That's Chris.
One of the groomsmen.
I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Hi, right, Sarah.
What if I take the quality control test of Bud Light?
Yeah, let's get breakfast. Or dinner.
What do you want to consider it?
Josh?
Alright, hey, and then I'm taking a shower. Seriously.
Yeah.
Where is it? What time is Charlie coming here?
Huh?
Excuse me?
What time did you get before you came?
1:30.
I know.
Love you.
Even when you pull it down?
Yeah. Good thing you're wearing a vest.
And the buttons, those things keep opening.
You don't have to use those buttons.
Yeah.
You can use the white ones.
I might have to because I won't stay closed with that.
I think just the ones up here you might want to use though.
There's a stretch band on the.
Yeah.
What time's the thing coming?
1:30.
Alright, plenty of time. Well, my rattler.
What's that you?
Ibuprofen, Xanax, allergy medicine, and acid relief.
Get the whole pharmacy. Oh, yeah, that's her. Alright, so that can go back in for the church. Make sure when you're holding it, you hold it down like that towards you.
Yep.
Some girls will have a tendency of holding it like this,
yep.
And then it looks silly. So
okay.
Keep it just like that.
All right.
Ready. Oh. Slide it up to you. There you go.
All right.
These are the three grandmothers.
Too?
So these are the grandmothers.
Okay.
So there's three grandmothers, two grandfathers, and these are the dads and the ring bearer.
Okay, we can leave one dad here.
Okay.
And Isaiah's here.
All right. And then the moms.
Who's the three grandmothers?
Grandma, Claire, and Nana.
Oh, Claire. Oh, I didn't even come to Claire.
And these
yet.
Are the two moms.
Okay.
One mom with the antique gold and the other one
beautiful.
I did with the cream.
Okay.
And then these are all, when you take them out, just before you go, I left them all in water for you because of the hydrangea, because I didn't want them to, so just pat them off with a paper towel. They're all in the blue, except for one is in the fuchsia-y color for the maid of honor.
Okay, so
that one. So, oh, here it is on this
end. That one's right over there. Okay.
Yeah, so just pat the stems with some paper towel.
All right. I guess the floor and everything are off. So you guys all dolled up, and as soon as we're going ahead and get makeup now.
Hey, we should all go up to the church like this. What? Is that Tux? What are you talking about?
What? Is this a problem here?
Thought we all went home. Look at him, though. He didn't come in.
Sorry,
he came dressed already.
If I was dressed already, I'd be drenched.
Yeah, me too.
I don't sweat that much. Oh, I do.
You found out where all the switches are now? The fans?
They're on the fans.
Yeah, just don't turn the fan on that blows out the Unity candle.
How do you feel?
Fine.
Woodchuck.
So you break out the compound bow.
Residential neighborhood, so I'm breaking out the 22.
22.
Oh, look at this one in his backyard, a big one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man.
Chris!
Last year in a woodchuck hole. That's a lot of beer.
That should last us to the church.
You have to have the trolley pull up to the back.
Yeah, really.
Yeah, what I do is I put the barrel of the gun inside of the noise of the bed.
Right. Sitting there, he's got the mouth hold open, he's got a hole over draped over his arm and stuff. We was like, where'd you get those? He's like, Matt Poison. He's like, we've been bagging them every day.
You said you were going to Quixus for that boat?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The other day. And he's like, oh.
Good, you got our ass kicked the way out and the whole way in.
What, bro?
To the boat. We stood the boat up, right? We hit one wave. The boat was like this, just boom.
How'd that motor do on that?
Burned an eighth of a tank there and back.
That's not bad at all.
But yeah, at 5,000 RPM.
Oh, that's not
bad. Right now, wait till we get hammered. Forget about it.
Yeah, because they're not going to be there till we're just about ready to go.
No paparazzi then.
Grandparents will be there, really.
Yeah, who?
Yahoo! Through your dad's comedy bell.
Right. Yeah, it's pretty quick. Well, you know.
I'm not used to jewelry.
I don't know whether to laugh or just put my head down when you made that comment yesterday in the pew.
Which
one? I don't know. I have no clue. I'm surprised that he even allowed it, to be honest. I mean, I don't think that they're there for today, you know.
They're only there half an hour. You think they could have waited for an hour?
He told me, he's like, oh, well, for your wedding, he's like, they're having a cook-off the night before downstairs in the basement. He's like, I hope it don't smell like chili.
Yeah, me too.
When the thing is?
I don't know.
That's
all. The hell is like it? No,
would you say Mitchell?
Oh,
hello?
Know.
Hi.
Well, kiss.
Well, there's a good snail. Just don't get any slime on me.
Ha, I tickled you.
You're such a silly kid.
Can I put you down yet?
Yeah.
All right. You're heavy and it's hot. You stay over here, that door's open. He's gonna keep his tattoo on.
You don't even see it under his shirt.
Come over here, buddy. He never brought the flowers to you guys?
For Pepe?
Yeah, oh, yeah. I have them.
You have them? Where are they?
Mom has them.
Mom has
the
them?
The ones for the grandfather?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Alright, you
get your
dad
out?
My keys.
Mine.
She's in the bathroom starting to get dressed.
Well, that's what I'm doing right now.
Yeah, I gotta eat something small at least.
Is he taping?
Yeah.
Right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, my
neighbor. Just put this on me really quick.
Did you buckle the thing on the inside?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, she did it the day.
Yeah, that's how mine is too.
Hi, Emily.
And you don't drink a Coca-Cola, do you
want
to dress? You
mean,
got me to hold a straw for you?
Yes, please. Yeah, or a straw something.
Do you want to shot a captain to go with it?
Like a long like a long
straw. I'd love
straw.
To, but not right now.
Alright.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going from the top down, and then I'm
going to
tuck the
either
I can put a bow or I can tuck
yep.
it in, okay?
And the bustle, I'll show you where it is later.
Oh, good.
This is painful. Jamie, can you get me my bracelet?
Yeah, where is it?
On the table and my necklace.
This is probably gonna be the hottest day of the whole summer.
Alright.
It's not raining.
Straws? I have no idea.
Right?
Yeah.
I
think
I don't know.
Come here.
Look at him.
Come on, we gotta put
his
shoes on.
I haven't put his
come
tie on yet.
Come here.
Let's Jeez. Put your shoes on, buddy.
Doing the moonwalk.
All right.
Let's put your sneakers on.
Beer on the porch. There's a
I don't want beer. I want like.
He has moose meat.
Food.
What do you want?
Oh, something.
Water.
Just a little bit of
are the girls even there?
Yeah, they're all getting filmed naked.
You can see Josh's house from here, can't you?
Yeah.
No.
No.
I think I'm gonna go over there and get ready with the girls.
Dude, you know my beers are so freaking cold. I left them in the truck all night.
Dude, that bag is no joke.
Yeah. Dude, it's still
ice cold. I got off the phone with you. I checked mine. Mine were all ice cold, too. Mine was in the house all night.
Well, told me. She's like, yeah, they've been in the bag since 3. I'm like,
I was ready to kill your cousin Jake
ice.
This morning.
Right.
8 o'clock in the morning, he's freaking ringing the doorbell like an asshole.
Who?
Jake! To drop this thing off. I'm like, leave it on the front porch. We'll get it later.
Is he over there getting ready with the girls? You gotta not be, dude. That's not right.
He's supposed to be here.
Alright.
Already. You know the Benoit way,
dude.
Dude,
forget it.
Better late than never.
Oh, shit.
That's David Carroll's address, so I drove by. Sure enough, they were in the garage.
Cousin Ryan.
Hey, Ryan.
Dana. John. Josh.
Pleasure to meet
you. Scott and Chris. And then Nigel's around here somewhere.
No, Nigel took my truck to go
get the flowers.
Oh, okay.
And Jake, of course, is still not here.
My brother's not here yet.
Which he'll be here probably.
Wait a minute, shouldn't everyone just be hanging out with a can of beer and.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah, let's do it.
No water.
Come on, we gotta get a funny picture.
Well, I need another beer.
Funny?
I didn't have one, I just
didn't have
one.
Now, let me just give you some advice. It's only funny if she knows about it. If she doesn't know about it, because once she knows about it, then you do
it. Grab me one,
you can smack it, and everyone laughs.
This is not a Clorox bleach bottle.
What is it? Hold it up, Dan. Hold it up so we can see what it is. Yeah.
I'll take a whack of that.
White lightning.
White lightning. You want a whack of it?
Chris took a couple of whacks of that.
Whack.
I mean.
Oh. All right, let's get a shot of all the guys with the beers just hanging out before we put clothes on.
The beers. Why do you have that yet?
Is it that nasty, really?
That put me on my ass quick
yeah,
that true. Night.
Oh.
It's strong.
Some good stuff.
Doesn't even phase
it's
right.
The
gasoline, huh?
Where's the groom? I need a groom.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
Yeah, I was chugging it right out of that bottle.
I gotta be able to stand up, not fall down.
Oh.
You my lady.
I thought that goes on the camp set.
Auto focus on this, huh?
No, he has to have.
Yeah, gotta stay still a little bit longer. Once the reskiting, get in closer together, there, guys. We'll get everyone the same picture.
We don't know each other.
We got a couple guys suited up already. A couple scrubs on the
other. There we go. Yeah, everyone's still looking over here, saying, "Take the picture for God's sakes. Let me see how you look."
Smile.
Oh, they look good. Oh, no, we don't smile. We say cold beer.
Cold
pretty
beer.
Girls. And for tonight, AC. Yeah, hold them out. Hold them out. Come on. Like, cheers. The party's starting already.
There you go.
Party start. Hey, who's the firefighter here?
Got a couple of them.
Couple of them?
One's just on Josh. Call still. So. Josh, you want to get more guns?
Oh, yeah. Come on. Do it.
Yeah, open up the safe. Let's get all the guns.
No, we only need
what?
One.
Yeah, dude. I don't want it.
What?
Yeah, bust them out.
Go show Ryan your arsenal.
We only need one. We don't need a whole
arsenal. No, everybody.
Ryan,
Hanson. Oh, here's the truck. Look at this thing coming up the street.
Is it here already?
Dude, wait till you meet Josh's dad.
I guess we better get ready.
Yeah, we all should get ready.
Yeah.
I can't get.
Pretty mommy looks.
You say pretty?
He wants the shoes. That's what he wants.
He wicked loves those shoes.
Look at mommy. Right,
I can't pick you up, buddy. All right, male. Of course, I just pull it.
I was just.
Yeah, we're just gonna have to straighten you out a little bit.
Are you doing that yourself? Let me do it.
Yeah, you saw what she did.
Yeah.
Right? Well, it needs to be straightened out.
No, it's 15 hours. Right?
Me too.
Yes,
15 hours. Emily, how does Auntie look?
Good.
Thank you.
I'm supposed to say very pretty.
You look very pretty too, Emily.
No.
You, right. Your crown
no.
matches Auntie Courtney.
Auntie Courtney.
Yes.
Look at my crown. And I think I can.
Look at my crown. It matches your crown. Mm-hmm. All right, I gotta go.
I haven't
seen
him yet.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, that's it. I'm ready.
Nobody's.
That's a bunch of stretches. I think we got somebody who knows what they're doing.
That's. Nigel's like a freaking legend at that place.
Yes, he is.
Well, he's been going since before he was
born.
Seriously,
yeah.
Is that their actual temperature?
What is it?
80
something?
So that's the plan. They're just going down to the campground. That's
Yeah.
They're hanging out there.
That
for
was their honeymoon. Yeah,
a week or so, and then coming back here. I'm gonna get over to the Bryce. see the shoot the girls before we get to
show. I don't need a picture of me getting help.
There we go.
Is it now tilted too much to the right?
I can't see.
Gumball number one!
Hey, there's the picture.
Is anybody else sweating yet?
Yeah, look, dude, this thing's already drenched.
Just sweat and air conditioning.
Scott, what's up with your bow, dude? That thing's beat.
The trolley just wiped out the bowl. That wasn't going to score any points.
No, that wasn't going to be a good stat. Now remember, Josh, if it feels comfortable, it's on wrong.
It's always comfortable.
Oh, yeah? You could be in the Guinness book. I never heard anyone say it was always comfortable.
Tell Josh not to get mad at Jake because
is Jake wearing that
yeah.
same vest?
Yeah, dude, I can't even feel my neck, dude.
You look sharp, dude.
Thank you.
I don't look
sharp. Sharp as a dull pack. Yeah, we can leave stuff on the trolley, right?
Yeah, like
yeah, because they're gonna take us around and they're gonna drop us off at the country club.
Right. My phone. Well,
my car is at St. Mary's, so if you need to put anything instead of leaving on the trolley, just throw it in the truck.
Right, does that feel better?
Is it okay? Straight?
Yeah. Don't do it, cuz.
He went to bed.
Oh, that's his stupidity. Thank God he's not in the wedding.
I felt like shit this morning.
You've had coffee control yet?
Yeah. Is that too tight?
No, it's fine. I have a big neck inherited from my father.
Dude, at least you don't got that gut, man.
Oh, shit. I gotta watch what I say.
You're in trouble.
Seriously.
It feels...
You look fantastic, bro.
Fantabulous.
You look like,
Dude, have one of the girls, honestly.
Yeah, it's
supposed
to ring up perfect, but that's fire.
I like those clouds building up over there.
Yeah. I don't know how to do that stuff, dude. We're gonna get your flower.
What?
We're gonna get your flower. What's that, a handkerchief?
Yeah.
By flower, you meant to pray.
I was gonna say everyone else has got blue. You got bubble gum.
I need the pink eye.
You guys done?
Yeah, not really, because I got.
I'm guessing they're gonna be blue too.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if I got the blue, man.
Hey, take the damn picture, won't you?
This fucking tie is a pain in the balls.
Pain in the ass. Yeah. Go ahead, put the shades on and do the men in black pose. You know, the cross arms. Like, oh yeah, I'm ready. All right, now lose the shades.
That's it. Yeah, you're looking over here saying, thank God today is the day. Thank God,
God today.
Thank God, yeah, none of those rainstorms.
Thank God.
That would be nasty. All right. We got one close on. We got Scott.
There's only two buttons on this?
Yeah, man. Are we going to be able to go back to the house later?
Where's the other best man?
One of Jake and Scott.
Jacob, where's?
My brother there. And Scott, I think, went to go walk some windows and doors and stuff.
One back.
Scott?
Yeah, you're both looking over here saying, take the damn picture. Go ahead, do the tough guy pose, men in black, yeah. Just like that, looking right over here. Go ahead, right about now, Nigel's saying, yeah, there's one last thing I was supposed to tell you about my sister. I forgot to say, yeah, I got it. Did you get it, Steve? That was good. Oh, man, that's going on the website for sure. Oh, yeah. And I could write captions on it.
You want to sell this flower?
Are you sure?
Let's stick it.
And tell my mom to bring my earrings.
Hot.
Tell the ones on the
computer. Yeah, it's going to feel good at 4 today.
Show.
Yeah, you're good. Yeah, I'll share a picture of the two of you. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Now, were you with him when he took it down there? Or?
No.
No? Oh, yeah. One, two. Two, three. I got it. Now just shaking hands. Saying, thank God today is finally here, man. Thank God. One, two, three. Nice. All right. Now.
Get her done.
He's looking for Jacob, right?
Jake.
What's up with this fucking tie?
Stop swearing on the camera. He's going to have to beep out everything.
Hey, Emily's going to watch this.
That's good. Well, my tie ain't straight.
Well, your head ain't straight either, but no complaining.
Oh, my head's sweating.
Your hairline ain't straight either.
Well, neither one of you.
Two, three. That's it. Just shaking hands this time, saying thank God.
Did my tie go crooked again?
Thank God. Yeah, look right at me when you're shaking hands. Nice.
Now the three of you together, turn that collar down there, Scott.
What collar?
The back part's all sticking up.
Jeez.
And then we got all the guys now. Who are we missing? If we get all of them, we can get. That's it. Get in close. Come on, pat them on the back. Say, don't worry about it, guy. Come on. You got the right girl. You got the right day.
Hey, the photographer's not as big a jerk as most of them.
I heard that. Okay. All right, who else are we missing here? We got everybody?
You all look like bubblegum.
Oh, we got Nigel with the cold enough. Come on, Dad, I'll be so proud of you. Yeah, the backup. Yeah. Steve, you got backup today.
I'm going to get Chris with the toilet.
All right.
Block my house.
All right.
Josh, doing good there, guy. I'm going to go shoot the girls. We'll see you in church. After church, we'll go
do
for
the bride
a trolley
first.
Ride.
Shoot the bride first.
Shoot the bride first. All right. Evidence.
You can
evidence.
Actually, give me a photo with Josh.
Come on over. Pat him on the back. Shake his hand.
Man. Fix his boutonniere. Whatever. Fix the boutonniere. It's been professionally put on. One, two, three.
Nice. All right, guys. We'll see you.
Hey, don't worry. I'll close all the doors.
Hey.
Heat.
Chris, are
in the trash can over there.
Maybe that wasn't a good idea, that AC. No, the beer was always a good idea.
You zoom out.
On top, yeah. Index finger is that little nub on top.
Is he like that other dude hangs out with all of
us? No, that's not it. Oh, okay.
Right where your index is, yeah.
I haven't hung out with him. Yes. Once they get the post. See him at the
end. Want to push him with the broom?
Wait. Scott's face is in the shade.
Obviously, it will be right there. So. Not yet. I don't know why. I just, I'm more warm than anything, you know?
Yeah, I know, me too.
Boy, it's too hot for this. But God bless the weather.
What
thank
a day
God.
You had.
I know.
Perhaps the better.
I know, knock on wood. Good. The man upstairs is.
He's watching out for you.
He is.
Very good.
Good.
So.
All right.
I'm glad that you guys obviously made it. I know you guys wouldn't miss it, so.
Never.
Okay, now everyone's looking over here. Give me some attitude. Yeah, come on. Yeah. How do you learn?
That was priceless.
I like these themes.
Good old Dana. Good old Dana.
You got it.
Hi, Nigel. How are you?
Good. Wait.
Yeah.
I got out to
come
all down.
I
got out to Jim.
That's not fair.
Come on, love. How you doing?
How's it going, Nana?
Moving on like a herd of cats. Oh, take your time. Take your time.
I
think I got a good seat for you if you're interested. It's a pew that sticks out a little further than the front ones. This is obviously for the wedding party, the males. The second one's for my parents. If you want to sit in the second row back. Jake, see the one where the ribbon is on the side or in front of Denise? Show her that one, because that one sticks out. You can see everything that's going on
there. There we go. Now, go ahead. Give him a hug. It's all right. It's a wedding. Come on. A double hug. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, I got it.
What's up, guys?
Oh, yeah, you better tell her that. I actually had 90% done the other day. The computer crashed. The car crashed.
So.
Yeah, we'll see then. Yeah.
Your hand goes under the veil. Under the veil.
Kiss back, go ahead, just for good luck. No, I want you to kiss her, Courtney. Kiss Mom. Thanks for putting up all that baloney 2 weeks ago. I don't mean any of those nasty things I said. Well, oh no!
All right.
Mom,
can you hold the paper? Erin.
Thank you.
Loving you to the A reading from the book of Sirach. Blessed the husband of a good wife, twice lengthened are his days. A worthy wife brings joy to her husband, peaceful and full is his life. A good wife is a generous gift, bestowed upon him who fears the Lord. Be he rich or poor, his heart is content, and a smile is ever on his face. A gracious wife delights her husband. Her thoughtfulness puts flesh on his bones. A gift from the Lord is her governed speech, and her firm virtue is of surpassing worth. Choicest of blessings is a modest wife, priceless her chaste soul. A holy and decent woman adds grace upon grace. Indeed, no price is worthy of her temperate soul. Like the sun rising in the Lord's heavens, the beauty of a virtuous wife is the radiance of her home. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you all. The word of the Lord.
Please stand.
From the Good News according to Mark. Jesus said, "From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. I must congratulate you guys on laying down the runner. I've never seen it run so direct and straight to the door. I'd like to see you do it as well the next time. There is a story about one young couple who went out for a romantic dinner one evening where a conversation inevitably got around to marriage. Now it seems that the young man here was saving up for some time for an engagement ring, but he was still in graduate school and in dire need of a computer. How did we manage before those items arrived? Anyway, the young lady was very understanding. She told him that, well, they had the rest of their lives to get engaged, and he should use his savings to buy himself a new computer instead of that all-important engagement ring. And while they were having dessert, the young man got up, reached into his pocket, and pulled out an absolutely magnificent engagement ring. And the young woman was stunned initially, very briefly. She recovered her composure in a hurry, looked up into his eyes and said, "Well, sweetheart, don't you have something to ask me?" And the young man immediately got down and bended knee. Actually, both knees. He was a very smart young man. And he whispered, "Honey, will you buy me a computer?" Now, she got a ring, he got his computer, and as the story goes, they lived happily ever after. At least, we hope so. Now, regardless of how a couple come together in the first place, or how that ring gets placed on the finger of the bride-to-be, whether the couple be dreamy-eyed or practical in approach, and I think you're pretty practical, we hope, indeed we trust that it is love, genuine love, that brings them together. That special love which prompts a man and woman to leave the shelter of their parental homes to be joined as one in unending love. And this love which they wish to share with each other is symbolic of that very special love which God wishes to share with each one of them through their very special and intimate married love. Now, there is a story about the young couple who had returned home from their honeymoon, and now they were talking things over. And the young husband said, "I promise you, dear, that I'm not going to be like one of those husbands who come home from work late every day and get upset because the dinner is overcooked or very cold." To which she sweetly replied, "If you do that, dear, I will certainly make it hot for you." Now, I'm not about to say that cooking makes a marriage, but I do venture to say that it tends to postpone a lot of unhappiness. And that brings me to the question that, a very important question that I've been asking for some years now, you might want to call it a profound question. What are you smiling at? Okay. You've been here before. How good of a cook are you, Josh? Very good. Okay. Are firemen always good cooks? I heard they are. Yeah. How about you, Courtney? You can't cook? No? But you can do hair and stuff like that. Okay. I almost ran her over this morning as she was coming from the beauty shop. I like to use that analogy for marriage. As we know, good cooking requires certain basic ingredients, solid ingredients, fresh ingredients. Also needs a degree of seasoning to flavor the food and sometimes to preserve the food. So also a good marriage needs certain basic good ingredients. Also a little, the equivalent of spice, if you will. Sense of humor, perhaps, to keep the marriage young and alive, and so preserve the union of marriage. There are indeed many, many ingredients in a loving marital relationship, because living in love with another human being does not at all mean constant bliss. Marriage is not always blissful. We have anybody here that agrees with that? Any married person? And you're not long married either, and you're taking that chance putting your hand up. I guess we've got a few very brave people, and we got others that are quite prudent. Marriage is not always blissful, not always hearts and flowers, wine and roses, because in marriage there's a degree of struggle. Sometimes there are misunderstandings, sometimes even loneliness. But the truth is, genuine love does not demand joy or bliss at each and every moment. Rather, two committed people are convinced of the goodness and the rightness of their married love, and so they can wait in patience when hard times seem very long. One of my favorite married stories is about the two scientists who had just returned home after spending 6 months in semi-isolation at the North Pole. And now they were being interviewed on local radio. And the woman was asked whether their living in such close quarters for that length of time had been a problem during those long 6 months. And she replied, "Not really. The only thing that bothered me was the way that he ate his cornflakes. The way he ate his cornflakes. Seems like a little silly thing. But sometimes it's just those little things added up, accumulating, that cause trouble. Like, for example, a dirty shoes or boots thrown in the middle of the beautiful living room floor. Or perhaps some food item that's been left completely open on the kitchen table all day long. Or, worst of all, those sweaty socks or underwear left on top of the bureau. Of course, I know that neither one of you will ever be found guilty of such a misdemeanor. Now, only a few short years ago, God called you into this world. And on the day of your baptisms, God called you to share his life and to share in his love. And today his call summons you once again. And the call that you receive here in the presence of the church is not a call to be served, but a call to serve. Not a call to self-indulgence, but a call to self-sacrifice and a call to love. Not a call to an easy life, but a call to share and to bear together the burden of a lifetime struggle. As St. Paul tells us in one of his writings, rejoicing in hope, but always, always patient in difficult times. You know your responsibilities. You should know your responsibilities. What you do not know is what lies ahead for you. Because the years of your lives will be filled with many things. Some laughter and some tears, some pain and some joy. But your love will grow more strong if you seek to walk together in faith through a Christian life fully and deeply shared, and God will bless you forever. One young married couple who had no children so far were driving home from a friend's home one day when they passed a garage where a father and a son were working together outside on a car. And seeing them, warm feelings flooded through the wife's mind as she noticed her husband was smiling. And he was happy. She was hoping to start a family and was happy that he was showing the same desire. And then he spoke his thoughts. I sure wish we had a garage like that. Life is full of little disappointments, little setbacks, temporary setbacks. In marriage, you will seek for many things, but you will seek not so much to be understood as to understand, not so much to be given as to give, not so much to be loved as to love. For as the great Saint Francis of Assisi told us hundreds of years ago, it is in giving that we receive. It is in forgiving that we are forgiven. And it is in dying to self that we are born to eternal life. And so I encourage you both, as you are about to take each other's hands for life, be strengthened in the Lord, trust in the Lord always, and be assured that he will never fail you. And then go forth from here asking his grace and his blessing, but knowing that here on this earth, God's work must always be yours. Amen.
too bad, right?
Fan feels good.
I guess we could call this the French Connection today. We have come to that special moment for which you have all come here today as family and friends. This special moment for which this young couple have been preparing for some time now. And so, as my dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses your love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Joshua and Courtney, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes, we have.
That's good. Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
That's good. Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I now invite you to join hands and to declare your consent before God and his church. Excuse me. Hey, Joshua. I, Joshua Benoit.
I, Joshua Benoit.
And take you, Courtney Photo.
Take you, Courtney Photo.
For my lawful wife.
For my lawful wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
I, Courtney Photo.
I, Courtney Photo.
Take you, Joshua Benoit.
Take you, Joshua Benoit.
For my lawful husband.
For my lawful husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
For sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, no one must divide.
I can use a little more of that.
We now bless the rings which Joshua and Courtney will exchange, the sign of their vowed love. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as the sign of your love and fidelity. Amen.
Amen.
I forgot to tell you that whoever does this best is the boss in the house.
Okay. Ready, baby?
Mm-hmm.
Courtney?
Courtney?
Take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Joshua.
Joshua.
Take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Congratulations, Joshua and Courtney Benoit.
Married, baby.
Now invite the bride and groom to light the center candle, symbolizing their union in Christian marriage.
And state, for heads of institutions, for heads of homes and households, that they will lead us and guide us in the search for God and the good life, in the search for peace and joy, in the search for love among us, let us pray to the Lord. For all married people, for those who married yesterday, for this new couple, Joshua and Courtney, married today, for those who will marry tomorrow, that they savor the joy of being together. Warm love and children, a long life, wine, but not too much, and friends, and a new day every day, let us pray to the Lord. For all young and single people who look forward to a vocation full of life and full of love, we pray to the Lord. For the lonely old and the lonely young, for the hungry rich and the hungry poor, for the sick in body, mind, and spirit, for the weak man in all of us, we pray to the Lord. For our relatives and friends who walk with us on life's journey, and for those who have gone before us to the other side of life, for the fulfillment of all their unfulfilled desires, we pray to the Lord. These are our words of prayer today for ourselves and all human beings. Tomorrow there will be others. Lord God, the beloved of humankind, who has first loved us, give our words by your listening the power of your word, so that all things may be accompanied sweetly and gently for the happiness of all, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Congregation, please be seated while the gifts of bread and wine are brought forward by Scott and Madison.
For the gift he's given me. And now, my sisters and brothers, let us pray that the gifts that we offer here be pleasing and acceptable to our Father in heaven. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church. O Lord, accept our offering for this newly married couple, Joshua and Courtney. By your love and providence, you have brought them together. Now bless them all the days of their married life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Let us lift up our hearts and give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we dwell always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him you entered into a new covenant with your people. You restored us to grace and the saving mystery of redemption. You gave us a share in the divine life through this union with Christ. You made us heirs of Christ's eternal glory. This outpouring of love in the new covenant of grace is symbolized in the marriage covenant that seals the love of husband and wife and reflects your divine plan of love. And so with the angels and all the saints in heaven, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise. Lord, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." And when supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of thy blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." And now let us together proclaim this mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Amen. Christ is risen. Amen. Christ will come again. Amen. Come in glory. Amen.
In memory of Christ's death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, this life-giving bread and this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share in the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love together with Benedict, our Pope, George, our Bishop, all the clergy, and all your faithful people. Remember all of our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, the martyrs, Blessed Damian, and all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. And now let us join our voices as we pray to the Father the words Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
My dear friends, let us ask God for his continued blessings in Joshua Courtney. Holy Father, Creator of the universe, maker of man and woman in your own likeness, source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray to you for Courtney, joined with her husband in the sacrament of marriage. May your fullest blessing come upon her and her husband, so that they may together rejoice in your gift of married love and enrich your church with their children. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy and turn to their sorrows. May they be glad that you help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in the world. May they reach old age in the company of their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, you said to your friends, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people. And grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
And now let us share with one another in his peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Do you want your address?
Peace be with you.
Yeah. Kiss you.
Right, peace be with you.
We're going this way.
Right.
Peace be with you, Cuzzo. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you. Joe, peace be with you. Peace be with you guys. Peace be with you. Peace be with you, buddy. Peace be with you.
Love you.
Peace be. Hi, ladies. Sexy as ever. Peace be with you.
Nice shoes.
Did you like it? I heard you guys chuckling.
Yeah.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you. I'd give you a kiss. Peace be with you guys. Peace be with you.
Beautiful.
Thanks. Peace be with you guys.
What's in your shoes?
Nothing.
Who told you?
This is Jesus who takes away our sins. He blesses Courtney, Joshua, and their union. Happy are we who are called to his table, loyal. But only say the word and I shall be healed.
Yeah, baby. I think your mother thought. Thank you.
hand show in the ring. Score points on the first play of the game, that guy.
I'm a little upset.
Wait, where are you going? I'm 9-1-2.
I don't know.
If I won, why can't
I? I don't know. Well, we didn't get to kiss the bride. I don't know why he didn't do it.
He didn't do that line either.
Woo! Can I go pee, please?
What?
Still shining, we're doing good.
Alicia, what are you doing?
You have air conditioning now?
What are you doing?
Yeah, I don't.
But you were looking at me too, so you were just listening.
Great,
do it again,
squeeze
together,
come on, get in there close,
come
on.
Nice.
Chris, you need to get in some pictures.
Yeah, let's go, Chris.
Yeah, Chris, get over here. I want to squeeze.
Do you want to take pictures anything?
No, we do it all at the four. We're going to do it all at the four.
All right, perfect.
Chris, want to have a quick cigarette, then we can go. Emily, Monday. Hi, babe. Yeah, but he's not here. He's
well, he was already there. I'm sitting in the garage.
I'll wait till the video guy.
Yes, David. No.
It's over.
Put
a little zipper in the back of the address.
Hey, they look good around here.
Did you see them?
Yeah, wrap it around.
We'll pick up our dates now.
Wrap it around.
Everybody's got flowers, that's to him.
Put them on your zippers.
We're gonna wrap it around the flowers.
There's nothing to...
Right there.
Then you need...
What am I gonna be all bowed up?
Wait a minute, the girls can use them.
I can't put one in the front too.
Well, I was going to stuff it down it.
Yeah. Around the flowers.
I was going to go like this.
That thunder? Boy, thunder boomers.
Yeah, heading this way. Thunder boomers.
Right. You better get going.
Good omen.
Oh, like, no, look, there's a thing right here. I forgot about this.
Huh? You want to put that in my hair?
Was it? Hey, as long as we have pictures. We left. Get pictures, get inside.
That was before
we left.
That's yours?
Yeah.
Girls with us, right?
What about my rock?
If you're wearing that, shouldn't he be holding the flowers?
Lynn, who's that?
I'm holding the flowers.
There we go. Get in closer. Come on.
She doesn't wear it inside.
Red, white, and there we go. Patriotic day. Yeah, watch. Nice.